So, you've received messages from the Lord to pastors, to Christians in general. I want to ask you a kind of question.
Okay.
How much anger do you think the Lord has engaged ministers who are deceiving people, like these false prophets? I mean, I'm not talking about pastors who have one or two weaknesses, human weaknesses.
Okay.
Maybe they have some struggles.
Yeah.
I'm not talking about those. I'm talking about those who use charms to bewitch their members who know that they have an idol somewhere and they are deceiving people. Yeah. How angry do you think the Lord is against them?
Well, the Lord is very, very angry against them. Because these people, they are deceiving through the means of deception and the powers of the devil. They are his creation, and not just his creation, they are his image and his likeness. So that is why he demonstrates more love and shows more concern towards humans, because we are his image and his likeness. So he pains him and he's angry when he sees these ministers going about deceiving his creation, that's human, we humans now. And that is why he warned, when he was on earth here, he said that beware of false prophets. He actually gave the warning because he knew that something of such is going to happen. And the reason why these things are having, should I say, growing rapidly by the days, because they're genuine servants of God. They have failed in their duty. They have failed in their duty. Many of them because of the things of this world. Many of them because of faith, money, different worldly assets. They have left their original calling. They have started preaching another gospel. And this has not given these false prophets legal grounds of claiming and influencing more people, more souls through deception, and they borrow their powers from the devil. Even there are some ministers also who were once genuine, but now they are corrupt. They are not using borrowed power from the devil. But all the same, whether you borrow power from the devil or you use the power of God, at the end, God will definitely judge. It is certain. It is certain.
Okay. So, I know that some men of God don't want to listen to anyone that says, I had an encounter, I visited heaven, I visited hell. Many people don't want to hear that kind of message. So what are some of the challenges you have faced in terms of rejection of your testimonies about heaven and hell? I mean, directly from notable Christians and men of God.
By the grace of God, is not actually strange to me, because the Lord actually told me that. He told me that many people, men of God, Christians, they are going to speak against you. They are going to hate you because of this. But he told me that I should not be afraid, but I should be of good cheer. He said, because they hated him when he was on earth. They hated him, and so they did all manners of evil against him. But he bared it because he knows his purpose here on earth. He said, if I discover that these things are happening to me, I shouldn't bother myself thinking about them, that my focus should be his work and his assignment for me. And I tell you the truth, I have received so many persecutions from notable men of God, believers. Even some of the people, they are from people who also believe what I believe, that's holiness. They believe what I believe. They believe in the fear of God. But some of them, in order for them to build empires for themselves, they intend to use a revelation which they actually had to build an empire for themselves, which is against God's purpose for it. And so other many men of God and believers also. I'm sorry to mention that one notable one is Sister Linda Porika. She actually spoke against me. She spoke against me that I say what the Lord did not show to me. I say what I did not hear. And other things also. But when I saw that, I laughed. Said, well, yeah, so it has come to this level that you come to speak against me in social media. I actually went back to the Lord to pray and ask God. And he told me, because actually people, when they saw it, some of them, they called me. Some of them were sending me messages that I shouldn't just keep quiet like that. I should reply her back. So I said, that is for you humans, but I have to hear from God first. So when I went to pray, the Lord told me never to reply her. Never to reply her, that he did not send me a message to come over to social media and start conflicting or quarreling, exchanging words, or in battle with anybody. That my focus should be on the assignment he gave to me. And during that, he also gave me 23 reasons, which I wrote down, about why he gives divine revelation. 23 reasons with stronger scriptural backings to it. So it's not new to me.
Okay, you said the Lord gave you 23 reasons why he gives divine revelations.
Yeah.
Okay, we may not look into that today, but if we invite you, Igwaibna invites you another time, would you please avail yourself to be here to talk to us?
Yeah, I will, definitely.
Okay,
I will.
So our viewers will be hearing more from Pastor Samuel Oghenetega, Emmanuel. Thank you for accepting our invitation.
It's my
and
pleasure.
Then what would you like to tell the body of Christ and the world in general?
Well, my advice to the body of Christ is that you have to put your hope on Christ and on him alone, because he is the author and the finisher of our faith. So you don't have to look unto man in serving God. You have to give your totality to God. That is why the Bible says that love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your mind, with all your soul. So that is my advice to every genuine child of God. In your good work and your relationship with God, make sure that you are always in the right standing with Christ. And then to the world at large is that, please, if you know you are not accepted Jesus as your Lord and personal Savior, please make haste and do so, because time is short, time is running out. Time is running out, and Jesus is already at the door. Jesus is at the door. So make a quality decision. Take the determined decision now to have a relationship with Jesus by accepting him into your life as your Lord and personal Savior, because he is the only way to the Father. There's no other way to heaven, no other way to God but through Jesus Christ. That is why the Bible says that there's no name given under heaven by which we might be saved except the name of Jesus. So it is only Jesus that can save you. It is only Jesus that can lead you to the Father. God bless you.
Okay, thank you.
Yeah.
So lastly, if somebody from other ministries would invite you, would you accept their invitation to share the word of God in their congregation?
Yeah, by the special grace of God, I will accept their invitation to share the word of God with them, but it depends on the Lord's permission. Yes, because whenever I get the invitation, I always go to the Lord in prayers and ask him if I should attend, that is, if I should honor the invitation or not, because there are some of these ministries who are satanic. They are just there to pollute God's servants. So That's why we believers, everything we do, we must always ask God for His will and direction. Because some of these ministries, their altars are polluted. Some of them are just there to pollute, and they corrupt the genuine children of God. So when I pray and the Lord gives me go ahead, I honor the invitation. But if He does not permit me, I rather place that invitation on pending until I get permission. And if He does not allow me, then I won't honor that invitation.
Okay, thank you very much for coming to join us on eagleeyeopener. God bless you.
God bless you.
I have been talking with Pastor Samuel Oghenetega, Emmanuel, and we've been discussing on some of the revelations encountered he actually had since he was just 14 years old, and we've been having a good time. I believe that our discussion this evening has blessed your life, and we pray that the Lord God will bring us together again so that we can still hear more from you. It's my pleasure having you on eagleeyeopener Global Outreach. God bless you.
God bless you, sir.
Okay, thank you. Thank you for joining us. If you have not subscribed to this channel, please do well to subscribe to our channel, eagleeyeopener, and also follow us on social media. God bless you. Bye-bye for now.